Okay, this is Webjet. If we can just move one more slide, please. So many of you know that we're in the travel business. We're a digital travel player. We've been around for 25 years and we've been listed on the Australian Stock Exchange for 25 years. What many people won't know about our business is even though we're Australia's leading online travel agency and New Zealand's leading online travel agency, the vast majority of our earnings don't come out of the Webjet brand, but they come from our overseas businesses, which is a combination of WebBeds, GoSee, Trip Ninja. We're sort of circa 75% of our profits from a business called WebBeds, which is a global travel marketplace where we connect hotel supply and demand. And I'll talk a little bit more about that just to give you some insight into what that business does and why it's been so successful for us. We run another niche travel agency, online travel agency business based out of New Zealand called GoSee, where we're a global leader in the provision of motorhomes and car rental. And we've also got an AI machine learning business called Trip Ninja. Horrible name, but great business. And what we try to do is take complexity out of the travel ecosystem. And we think there's great opportunities for that business. So if you look at our business in 2023, financial year 2023, we were more than 2,000 people operating in 50 plus countries, serving 1.1 million customers. We facilitated 7.4 million bookings, which generated 4.35 billion in TTV, 364 million in revenue and 134 million in EBITDA. So if we move to the next slide, and the one after that. I'm going to talk a little bit about WebBeds. And what WebBeds does is it connects travel sellers and travel buyers in the B2B marketplace. And we do that when we do that through a form of disruption where we entered the market in 2013. And we thought that there was an opportunity for an Australian-based company that could put in place a different business model to the existing players. And we used to call it the multi-supply aggregation strategy. And what our strategy is, and you see it on the left-hand side of this diagram, it's to have an optimal number of independent hotels where we have a one-to-one relationship and we negotiate a rate and we negotiate an allotment and they're exclusive to us. And we have over 31,000 of those directly contracted rates today. We also want to connect to every major hotel chain in the world. And we've done that. And we also, to broaden our range and to provide the long tail, we've connected with 70 third-party providers. So 70 other people who have got rates and availability are connected onto our site. The net of all of that is that we have over 400,000 hotels for sale. We have many hotels where we get different price points from our different partners, so either ourselves, a directly contracted hotel, or through a third-party provider. And sometimes we might get 10 different rates from a third-party provider, and we enable that to go to our buyers or the people on the demand side, and we're able to fulfill the need of retail channels, which are other online travel agencies, and we provide our inventory to the largest online travel agencies in the world, all the brands that you would know. We provide to corporate travel agencies. We provide to retail travel agencies, including all the major retail travel agencies, even in Australia, even though we compete with them on the Webjet side. And then to wholesale travel agents, whether they're a tour operator or a DMC or a tourism board or any other form of wholesaler, as well as the emerging channels of super apps and loyalty programs and travel lifestyle apps, etc. So we provide that across the board. So it's a combination of all the stuff on the left-hand side being facilitated predominantly through technology and API connections to all of those buyers on the right-hand side. And we deliver our 430,000 hotels in 16,000 destinations across 190 countries to 44,000 individual travel buyers in 139 markets, generating a booking every 5 seconds. So that's our fastest growing business. It's the one that drives the majority of our earnings, and it's the one that will continue to be our fastest growing business for the foreseeable future. If we go to the next slide, our global footprint for this particular business unit is 1,500 people, and we operate in 15 languages in 120 cities, and we have people based in 50 countries. And as I mentioned, we source inventory from over 190 markets and we sell to 150. So it's a big business and it's a truly global business. Next slide. And let's put that into perspective. Our business is diversified across four geographic regions of Europe, Middle East and Africa, the Americas and APAC. And we've given data that shows what our business looked like pre-COVID to what it looks like today. And you can see the transformation that's occurred. Our business pre-COVID generated circa 40% of its bookings and about 48% of its TTV and an even greater percentage of its revenue in Europe. And we can now see that Europe only accounts for 42% of our revenue. And the business has grown considerably against those pre-COVID numbers. So if you look at where the improvements come, it's in APAC, which from a bookings level was at 36%. It's, sorry, TTV was 36%. It's grown substantially. Americas has grown substantially. And where it's declined has been in the Middle East. And that's a factor of us changing the way we trade with that particular region. So we're a global business that is fundamentally different to where we were pre-pandemic. And we continue to see great growth opportunities across that business. And if we were to project out 3 to 4 years from today, we would see the Americas and APAC being substantially bigger and more germane to our overall mix of both bookings and TTV. If we move to the next slide, please. And the one after that. So at our, we're on a 1st of April to 31st of March financial year. So we just presented our first half results for financial year 24. So we did that 2 weeks ago in November. This is data till the end of September. As you can see, our business, all our metrics are materially ahead of the first half of 23. The earlier presentation from NAB spoke a little bit about underlying trends across the markets. I can say that in the travel market, we continue to see a high level of resilience and we continue to see strong growth, and they're reflected in the broader market, but they're certainly reflected in the results that we're able to generate for the Webjet business. As you can see, our bookings are up 27% on the first half of last year at 4.37 million for the half. Our TTV is up 35% at circa 2.9 billion. And the bookings number is a reflection of the WebBeds business being up 50%. And the TTV number is a reflection of both WebBeds and the return of international travel for our Webjet business based in Australia. Go to revenue. We can see that we're up 39%. The business has done a good job in capturing revenue at a greater rate than its underlying sales or TTV number, as you can see on the various charts. And finally, and most importantly, our EBITDA number is up 41% at 102.1 million Australian dollars for the half, which is best in class EBITDA margins. And we are one of the few global travel businesses that has an EBITDA margin across our aggregate business in excess of 40%, which we're naturally delighted with. If we move to the final slide, I spoke that global demand or global travel demand remains resilient. We have a view that notwithstanding the difficult macro environmental environment that we're all operating in and the geopolitical tension in particular in Gaza at the moment has not dampened travel demand. It certainly has for the Middle East, but our other three major regions of APAC, Europe and the Americas continuing to grow. And we're expecting a record full year result. Our FY24 EBITDA is expected to be between $180 and $190 million. As I've spoken about in this presentation, it's driven primarily by the growth in the WebBeds business, where second half performance is expected to continue the record performance that we saw in the first half. On the webjet.com.au business, the OTA business that the vast majority of people on this audience will have booked through, our EBITDA result in the second half will be similar to that in the first half. And GoSee, our niche OTA business based in New Zealand for motorhomes and cars, is expected also to have a consistent second half to first half. So overall, record result of 180 to 190 million. And Ian, I'm happy to take any questions that you may have received from the audience.
Thank you, John. And we have. I'll come to those in 1 second. I may have missed this, but you used a term through your presentation, TTV. Just what's that mean?
It's total transaction value. And when you sell something in the travel industry, you're not the merchant of record in most case. You're selling somebody else's product, like an airfare. And then that's what we would call TTV. And same for a hotel. That's the value of the hotel room that we sell. And the revenue number is our take out of that TTV number. And across our business, it's circa 8.5% as a take rate against that TTV number.
Right. Thank you for that. Sort of related to this, the first question relates to international flight bookings, B2C, business to customer. Aside from the booking and guarantee fees, do you receive any commissions or overrides from the airline?
We do. One of the reasons that Webjet business has not recovered at a profit level to pre-COVID levels is because that commission rate has changed over the course of the last few years. It was typically around about 5% pre-COVID. It's now 1%. So we're seeing an 80% drop in commission rates. So that's the implication is that lower revenue across the same sales that we've had historically has resulted in slightly lower profit than it was pre-COVID.
I was really surprised to learn about WebBeds, to be frank. It's something I hadn't thought about. And as you said in your closing remarks, most of us know about Webjet and when we book for travel and stuff. What are the global competitors for WebBeds?
The largest player is Hotelbeds. They're based in Palma, Mallorca. We are a new entrant in the market. We've only been in existence for just on 10 years. I remember in February of 2013, when we launched the business, we sold $14,000 worth of hotels. That was our TTV, not our revenue, in that first month. and we're on track to do circa 4 billion Australian dollars this year. So we've had exceedingly strong growth over that intervening 10-year period. We've made some acquisitions that have helped us achieve those numbers. And the consequence of doing all of that means that our business, our web beds business, is now the second largest in that B2B hotel intermediary or hotel wholesaler space. So that we're the top two, and then there's a big gap to sort of number three. So they would be about 30 to 40% of our volumes, the number three player in the market.
Right. Well, you mentioned acquisitions and organic growth. Where's the big market opportunity for WebBeds?
Oh, we're delighted to achieve the results that we have, where our booking numbers are up 50% ahead of pre-COVID numbers, and we've done that organically. So one of the primary focuses of our business is that we can outcompete our competitor base, and we can improve our conversion rate. We've got enough clients to sustain our growth for the next 5 to 10 years. We have 44,000 people who connect to our sites daily and make bookings. So we just need to get them to make more bookings for us versus our competitors, because it's like a panel. There's a choice for them to make their hotel bookings. And we think the opportunity for us exists to increase our conversion rates. And we've said publicly in the past, and we're not going to shy away from it, that even though we're doing 4 billion in TTV today, our longer-term audacious goal is to get to 10 billion in the WebBeds business.
Right. We all know that the travel industry in particular was hit very hard by the pandemic. And I guess there's been a lot of lessons learned from that. Have you put in place contingency plans for future scenarios, not necessarily a pandemic, but such a similar black swan disaster?
As Ian, you're sort of my ilk. We've been around for a little while. We are a victim of the circumstances we find ourselves in, and Webjet, as a public listed company, has learnt a lot from the pandemic. We suffered to an even greater extent than the 30% market sell-off that occurred at that particular point. Our business was basically legislated as illegal, and we had to sustain a significant cost base. To that end, we're sitting on now circa $600 million of cash, and if there was to be any other event, heaven forbid, the working capital unwind and the ability to sustain our business, we would make sure we would have at least a year's worth of cash reserves to sustain that organization. And that's why we're sitting on the 600 million of cash that we've got today.
Okay. You're not doing yourself any favors by putting us in the same basket. I'm suggesting you're doing better than I am. One last quick one to finish on, a special interest question. Where's the best place to travel to at the moment? I guess that's for you, as a combination of Webjet and WebBeds. What's your recommendation?
Look, remarkably, if you're an Australian traveler, the most popular destination is still Bali. On popularity for Australians, Bali is number one. And I'm going to say where I want to go. So I'll make it very personal. I want to go to Lizard Island when I'm next in Australia. So I'm not actually based in Australia, but when I come back for our full year results, I want to go to Lizard Island for a week and experience the best of far North Queensland.
Well, John, I hope you're able to do that. I'm sure you will be able to. We wish you well, in a business sense as well as into 2020. Thank you for joining us this morning on ASX CA Connect.
Thanks for having me. Appreciate it.
Our pleasure.